Dear students, today we are going to discuss one of the most important topic in absorption called solvent selection. In absorption, you have some gaseous phase or gaseous mixture or vapor mixture with some pollutant or contaminant or valuable component to be removed in it. This red color particles denotes the solute, which can be a pollutant or contaminant or valuable component to be removed. So you are interested in remove this red color particles. So this red color particles can be a pollutant, contaminant or valuable component. For that we take the help of the separation operation called absorption. For that we bring this gaseous mixture into contact with some liquid phase. So this liquid phase is called solvent. So which can be a pure solvent or recycle one. So this solution or liquid phase which is brought into contact with the gaseous phase is called solvent. When the solvent on gaseous phase are brought into contact, this solvent absorbs all the solute particles present in gaseous phase because of its affinity towards these solute particles, so that you can get a purified gaseous phase or the gaseous phase which is freed from the pollutant. Now the question is, how do we select this solvent? So which solvent should be used? What are the criteria? Generally we cannot use a same solution or solvent for all the separation or for all absorption process. So for each system we need a separate solvent or suitable solvent. How can we determine the suitability of the solvent for the particular separation? For that we have different criteria, we will discuss one by one. First criteria is solubility of gas. So the gas or solute, you can say that solute. So your solvent should have high solubility towards this solute component. That means it should have the capability to absorb the solute component, or it should have high affinity towards the solute component so that it can attract the solute particles from gaseous phase to liquid phase. Suppose if you have a number of solutions A, B, C, D, which are having same solubility values, which are equally having same affinity values towards solute, then how do we choose among them? Then you can choose the solvent with low molecular weight. Why? Because suppose if you require 10 moles of solvent for the particular separation. So if your molecular weight is 30, then you may need 300 grams of solvent. If your molecular weight is 50, then you may need 500 grams of solvent. That means if you are selecting the solvent with a low molecular weight, means you are reducing the quantity required, quantity of the solvent required for the separation. Because of that reason, you can select a solvent with a low molecular weight, right? So this is the first criteria for selection of solvent. The second criteria to be followed is chemical reactivity. Generally, if the solvent is reactive towards the solute, then the absorption is high because it has higher affinity, higher attractiveness. So it can absorb all the solute and forms a new product. Now the question is whether we have to select a solvent with a chemical reactivity or not. If you are interested in regenerating the solvent, then you should not use the solvent with a chemical reactivity. That means if you are having a column, absorption column, in which you are sending solvent from top and gaseous phase from which we need to recover the solute from bottom. Now when these phases come into contact into the column, when these two phases are brought into contact in the column, then that solute transfer takes place from gas phase to liquid phase, and the solvent with absorbed solute leaves the column as a solution, and the purified gas mixture leaves the column from the top. Now the question is whether we have to select the solvent with a chemical reactivity towards the solute or not. This solvent plus solute, if you are interested in utilizing this mixture as a whole, then you can select a solvent with a chemical reactivity. Otherwise, if you are interested in recovering this solvent for further processing or recycling, that means this solvent can be recycled for another absorption process, another cycle of absorption process. Suppose if you are interested in recovering this solvent for further separation, then you should not select the solvent with a chemical reactivity. That means your solvent should be inert towards this solute, but it should have some affinity, or so it should have high solubility towards the solute. It should only dissolve the solute, it should not react with the solute. But if you are interested in utilizing this whole mixture as a solution or a new product, then you can select a solvent which can react with the solute. So in this way you can select solvent with respect to chemical reactivity. The criteria to be followed is volatility of the solvent. So volatility of the solvent, if your solvent is more volatile, that means it has low boiling point which can cause high vapor losses, due to vaporization during the process, which is a loss to the process. So your solvent should have low volatility so that you can reduce your vaporization losses. Sometimes it may be needed to select more volatile component with respect to solubility levels. That means suppose if you are having solvent A and B. Now solvent A is more volatile and B is less volatile compared to A, and but solvent A has more solubility compared to solvent B. Now my question is our task is to choose a good solvent among between A and B. Suppose if I am interested in choosing A, then I need to compromise on vaporization losses. If I want to choose solvent B, I need to compromise on solubility. So how do we choose? So in that way, suppose if you are forced to choose solvent A, then you have to make a provision to recover the vaporization loss of solvent A through because of the more volatility. That means the vapors needs to be collected again, and you have to recover those vapor losses or the component losses somehow by condensation or something, some other means. That means you have to make an extra provision to recover the vapor losses in solvent A. So in that way you can make a choice, right? So as long as you have the provision to select a solvent, so please go for as long as you have a provision to select a solvent with equal solubility levels, then you can choose a solvent with less volatility. So in that way, thus volatility can be a criteria for the selection of solvent. Now the fourth criteria to be followed in selection of solvent is corrosiveness. As we all know that the liquid or the solvent which we are handling should not damage our equipment during the separation operation, because it should not corrode the equipment, it should not corrode the auxiliary equipment or any material coming to contact with this liquid. So it should not be corrosive towards the material which we are handling. So it should not be corrosive towards the material of construction of the fifth criteria to be followed is viscosity of the liquid or solvent. So the viscosity of the liquid should be low, because if the viscosity of the liquid is low, then you require only a less power required for the pumping. So pumping energy can be reduced, and heat generation can be minimized. So because of these benefits, your solvent should have low viscosity. High viscosity means you require more power to pump this liquid into the column. Then flammability. The next criteria is flammability of the solvent. So as we know that the liquid which we are handling, the solvent which we are handling, should be non-flammable, because flammable liquids may cause fire explosions. So that's why to avoid such hazards, we require a solvent which is a non-flammable liquid. So the seventh criteria to be followed is toxicity. So as we know that, simply we can say that the solvent which we are handling, it should be non-toxic. So it should not harm either the environment or the human being who is handling that separation process or operation. The eighth criteria to be followed is freezing point of the solvent. The freezing point is the temperature at which the liquid can be freezed into a solid phase. Suppose if you have a liquid with a 30 degrees freezing point, or a liquid B with a 0 degrees freezing point. That means as soon as the ambient temperature reaches 30 degrees, the solvent A is freezed into a solid A. Similarly, for the B, in order to be freezed into a solid B, it requires 0 degree Celsius. That means you can avoid the freezing in a cold weathers if you use this solvent B. That means if you are living in a cold country, that means where the ambient temperatures can go up to 10 degree Celsius. That means if you use this solvent A, then your separation process or operation may suffer due to the freezing of solvent A in the column. But if you use B in that column, then you need not face this problem of freezing of solvent in the column. So in that way, you can choose a solvent with a low freezing point. So generally, we select a solvent with a low freezing point so that we can avoid the freezing of solvent in the operation. Ninth one, that's chemical stability. So your solvent should not be decomposed during the storage or during the process. So your solvent should be stable at all temperatures and pressures, whatever the pressure range or temperature range we are using in the separation process. That means your solvent, suppose if it is decomposed at high temperature or pressure, which can occur in a column, then you should not use that solvent, because it lose its chemical properties. So that's why your solvent should be stable under the conditions which we are handling in the process. And 10th one is cost. Obviously, you should get your solvent at a lowest possible rate. That means you should get the solvent at a low cost to the maximum possible. And 11th one is recoverability. So that means how easily you can recover your solvent. Suppose if you are using a solvent and if you want to reuse that solvent for the further separation, then you have to recover that solvent or recycle the solvent. So how easily you can recover the solvent, that also play an important role in choosing a solvent for this absorption operation. So these are the 11 criteria to be followed in choosing a solvent for the separation of absorption process or operation. So first one is solubility of gas, second one is chemical reactivity, third one is volatility of the solvent and corrosiveness, viscosity, flammability, toxicity, freezing point, chemical stability, cost and recoverability. All these criteria play an equal role in choosing a good solvent for the process. So how well you are choosing a solvent, that can affect your efficiency of your absorption process. Thank you.